this old train breaks down, then I could take a walk around, see what there is to see. Time is just a melody, with all the people in the street walking fast as the feet can take them. I just roll through town, and though my window's got a view, well, the frame I'm looking through seems to have no concern for now. So for now, this engine screams out loud, centipede gonna crawl westbound. So I don't even make a sound, cause it's gonna sting me when I leave this town. And all the people in the street that'll never get to meet, these tracks don't bend somehow. And I got no time that I got to get to where I don't need to be.
Would make it Glen close. Sorry.
But I can't stop that.
Where's the trail? meadow. And then Forester Pass, over 13,000 feet.
And then it's on to Whitney.
It makes you feel really small.
Today is day 19, something like that. And if all goes well, I will be going up and over Forester Pass, the last pass before Whitney, and the highest point on the Pacific Crest Trail. It's over 13,000 feet. But I don't know that yet. These passes are getting a little tall and a little ridiculous, so. This morning, I came up with a brilliant plan to get over them a lot faster and easier. A catapult.
Didn't work.
Look at this stream. Where is it coming from?
That is not a mirage. The water is so clear. It is that blue because, of course, it's reflecting this ridiculously blue sky. That is just so beautiful. Pure snowmelt up here, almost at the top of Forester Pass. That is gorgeous. There's no air up here. I can't stop looking at it. That is absolutely amazing. That's bluer than Lake Tahoe. God. That's why I love doing this, because you see that? Yeah. That is amazing. Anyway, it is to me. Almost there. Okay, Forester Pass is no joke, in the sense that this ridge walk is a ridge walk. Now, I don't get vertigo, but I'm starting to. This thing drops off. And drops off. And I've been walking on this thing down. Forester Pass, 13,200 feet. I've now done all the passes on the John Muir Trail. I'm at the tallest point
on the Pacific Crest Trail. That's pretty cool. 13,200 feet. And now it's just on to Whitney. In 3 days? How many days? I don't know how many days, just a few. I can't believe how beautiful it is up here. I mean, who would have thought just barren rock would be so pretty? And the sky is so blue, and the water is so blue. Anyway, this is why I do it. This is why I come out here, because I get to see this. I get to see blue sky, and I get to be up this high, and that rhymed. Anyway, now it's a long way down. And I can't believe there's not a cloud in the sky. After a week of thunder and lightning, this is absolutely amazing. I mean, just... Hope it's like this on Whitney. I guess I should go down, huh? Look at this place. This whole valley is over 12,000 feet. It's higher than Mather Pass, Pinchot Pass. I can't believe I'm here. This is like, it's like a whole other world. It's more like the moon than any of those other places. There's a Forester Pass. I just can't believe I'm here. It's just awesome. And the blue, blue sky!
We are in the mountains, and they are in us, a part of all nature, neither old nor young, sick nor well, but immortal. There is not a fragment in all of nature, for every relative fragment of one thing is a full harmonious unit in itself. But when we tug at a single thing in nature, we find it attached to the rest of the world. John Muir.
narrating.
Here's where I turn off the PCT. Take the John Muir exclusively to Mount Whitney, 8.3 miles. I should be able to see her any time now. I'm emotional just thinking about it.
You can see her poking up off the top there behind Mount Young. There's Mount Whitney.
I guess I really won't get the full view until I'm down to this valley and around up to Guitar Lake at the base. That's tomorrow. And this high altitude is taking away my voice.
Hate them.